True. Go.
I am delighted to hear that the Supreme Court has given me protection from arrest. I am deeply grateful to the Supreme Court for also upholding my constitutional right to report and broadcast, and for defending my freedom of expression and my freedom as a journalist. As you all know, there have been over 150 FIRs that have been filed by the Congress Party in a clear attempt to intimidate me and my network from reporting, especially on the Palghar incident. I am very grateful that the Supreme Court has not allowed the Congress Party to harass and intimidate me and my network by filing hundreds of cases, especially in states which are Congress ruled. As you are all aware, Congress leaders have been intimidating me and have been threatening me with physical violence. I am deeply grateful that the Supreme Court has noted the violent assault on me and my wife, Samyabrata Ray, editor of Republic, day before night. I am very grateful that the Supreme Court, taking view of the violent attack on me by Congress workers, has asked the Mumbai Police Commissioner to look into the security of my physical establishment, the Republic Network Studio, and for me personally. For all of this, I am deeply indebted to the Supreme Court of India. My faith in the country's highest court, to the Supreme Court of India. My faith in the country's highest court as a working professional has been upheld even higher today. And I bow down to the Supreme Court for the manner in which they have defended my rights as a journalist today. I am deeply grateful to the millions of people who have supported me. I am deeply grateful to citizens of India who have written to me at a time when me and my family are being subject to harassment by the Congress Party leadership. And I request the Congress Party leadership to reconsider its path of trying to coerce and intimidate a journalist in the line of duty, to take things out of context and to use wrong and fake social media handles to intimidate me. My dear friends, in the course of the last 72 hours, numerous attempts of physical violence and threats of physical violence have been made against me. My phone number is being circulated by people associated with that political party, and I am being attacked and abused constantly on a daily basis. I can share the details of the people who on the phone have been abusing me and attacking me. And I just want to tell all of them, this kind of hate and intimidation can never win. It has never won, and it will never win in an independent country. I am not going to be cowed down by the physical violence, by the threats, and with the abuse. It will make my resolve to report independently even firmer. And I also want to tell the lawyers of the Congress Party that it is absolutely unethical to report independently even firmer. And I also want to tell the lawyers of the Congress Party that it is absolutely unethical to take a 30-second clipping out of 100 hours of programming and have the temerity to raise these, misrepresent, change the context, and try and vilify an individual or an organization. I am grateful to all the media bodies, to my fellow journalists, to people from all across the country, to people from every part of the country. I am deeply and deeply grateful for your love and support. We will continue to report fearlessly. And once again, I thank you all for your strong support, which means the world to me. I carry that support in my heart, and it makes me stronger every day, and especially at this point, as one Indian to another. I thank you all, and once again I thank the Supreme Court of India for defending me at this time.